On the eastern side of India, bordering the Bay of Bengal, there existed a kingdom. Legend has it that the rocks used to make this kingdom are as old as Earth itself. In the years to come, this land went through a battle which changed the life of its king. I'm sure we've all read it in our history books. We're talking about King Ashoka, and the land is the ancient land of Kalinga. And as time passed by, the Eastern Territories got filled with temples, stories, myths, legends, and delicious food, all surrounded by lush green and beautiful landscapes. Welcome to the fabled land of the sun god. Welcome to Odisha. Just a few kilometers away from each other, Puri, Bhuvaneshwar and Konark make the golden triangle of Odisha. I am on this highway starting my journey to come across the most ancient sun god temple in India. All right, so I'm standing here in front of an architectural wonder of eastern India, which is once upon a time called the Black Pagoda. And the reason why it was called that was because this place was responsible for most of the shipwrecks and accidents that took place back in the day in the sea. Well, now what if I tell you that this place is actually one of the most revered shrines of the sun god? I am at the Konark Temple, and if you are wondering how can a structure as grand as this be responsible for all the accidents and shipwrecks, well, this is when the story gets magical. Built in the 13th century by Narasimha Dev, it took him approximately 12 years to complete this temple. And this is the magical part. You see that part right up there? There used to be a huge magnet with like iron plates after every rock, which actually made it into a magnetic field. And there used to be an idol in the middle, and it used to levitate up in the air. How cool was that? Although the phenomenon amazed the locals, unfortunately, the magnet had to be taken down for two main reasons. The first one being that it disrupted the navigation system of all the ships that used to come in back in the days. And second, it actually changed the tidal patterns over the years. Now what's left of this place is a shrine of the sun god, which you should definitely visit when you come to Odisha. भैया आपका नाम
टिकेश्वर साहब
टिकेश्वर मेरा नाम नील नाइस टू मीट यू अच्छा तो ये जो कोणार्क मंदिर है पीछे हाँ इसकी कहानी जानते हो
हाँ जानते हैं
कि ऊपर एक बहुत बड़ा चुंबक हुआ करता था और उसकी वजह से जो सारे जो शिप आया करते थे वो गुम जाते थे हाँ तो उसी हिसाब से मैं आपको कुछ दिखाना चाहता हूँ ठीक है मेरे पास यहाँ पे पत्ते हैं जानते हो सारे पत्ते ठीक है एक बार फेंट देते हैं इसे
ठीक है
सारे फिट गए ठीक है तो ऐसा करते हैं एक कोई भी पत्ता निकालो ठीक है दिखा दो सबको मैं भी देख सकता हूँ
आप भी देख सकते हो हाँ अभी
हाँ कोई नहीं मैं देख सकता हूँ ठीक है तो ये जो हमारा पान का हुक्म है ठीक है इसे एक शिप की तरह मानो ठीक है तो ये जाती थी अंदर ठीक है ये गया अंदर देखा
क्या देखा
देखा वापस ऊपर आ गया
नहीं आएगा
नहीं आया
कैसे
बाप रे
आ गया ये नहीं होता है
एक और बार करें निकालो 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 दिखा देखा देखो ठीक है सबको दिखा दो ठीक है आप कभी भी रोकने को बोलो ठीक है ये गया एक बार फेंट दे
फेंट दो
अरे हम वैसे नहीं फेंटते हम ऐसे फेंटते हैं ठीक है, अब हमारे पास अपनी स्किल है तो हम अब यूज करेंगे ना. हाथ दो अपना. ये था अच्छा दो. तो ये क्या है? बादशाह. किसका?
कला
का. कला बन बादशाह.
अपना दूसरा हाथ ऊपर रखो. सोचो सोचो पत्ते के बारे में.
सोच लिया.
ये जो आपके हाथ में जो काला बादशाह है, इसे सोचो ये आपके पत्ते में बदल रहा है.
हाँ, बदला ये तो.
हाँ, सोच लिया.
सोच लिया.
पलट के देखो. जादू से ज्यादा क्या अच्छा है?
आप अच्छे हो.
Around 55 kilometers away from the Konark Temple is a city that boasts of having the most number of temples in the world. Next up on the Golden Triangle, I am on the way to Bhuvaneshwar. But as we already know, there's this one quiet spot in every city that every traveler yearns for. But when in Bhuvaneshwar, that quiet corner translates into a beautiful lagoon. Spread over 12 acres with rooms and suites built on a lake, this place is one of its kind. One panoramic view and you'll be transported into the greens of Odisha. How can you not come here when you come all the way to Bhuvaneshwar? Welcome to Mayfair Lagoon. So I'm here sitting with the resort manager of Mayfair Lagoon, Mr. Dilip Chhabra. Thank you for having us.
Pleasure meeting you, Neel.
I have to say, great place. I've been walking a long way and I still haven't completed the whole thing. So how long is this place?
The property is about 12 acres, right? Wow. Out of 12 acres, it's about 1.8 acres approximately of lagoon.
Alright, so for all the viewers watching at home, when they obviously come to Odisha, they come to Bhuvaneshwar, they'll come stay over here. So what does Mayfair Lagoon have to offer all of them?
Mayfair Lagoon, the jewel of East. That's the best part to understand first. You have life in this hotel, right? And you have lagoon, you have fountains, you have 9 restaurants, which is a food and beverage outlet. So everything what you get is under one roof.
Alright, so out of all the 9 restaurants, which one would you ask me to go to first?
Neel, since you're in Odisha, I would suggest you to go to Kalinga. That's the Odia restaurant, since you're in Odisha, so you must try the Odisha cuisine also.
Is it the traditional Odian thali?
It is the traditional Odian thali, right? Nice. Cooked, home-cooked food, okay. Very delicious. You'll really love to have that food.
Nice. Pleasure. So let's go have some. Thank you so much.
Enjoy yourself. Enjoy your food.
Alright, so there are 2 reasons why you would absolutely love Odian food. The first one being that it uses very less oil. And the second one, back in the days, they used to serve Odian food on disposable plates made of sal leaves. And interestingly, that food has trickled down over the years through the temple, which is why it's mainly vegetarian, which makes me very happy. So without further ado, let's call for what the chef has in store. Excuse me. Alright, so the thali is here and I'm surprisingly thrilled because this looks and smells absolutely delicious. And to tell me more about this, I have the sous chef, Mr. Sibanand. Thank you for having me. So, What is all of this? This looks amazing.
We are serving two varieties of rice. One is sweet,
okay,
and one is normal one.
This is the sweet one.
That is the kanika, known as kanika.
Okay, this is kanika, which is the sweet one.
Yes, sir.
This is the normal steamed rice.
That is normally steamed rice.
Okay.
It's a dalma. It's made out of lentils,
okay,
and vegetables, tempered with cumin and dry chilies. That is known as jani posto. It's known as jani posto. In Oriya, we are telling jani. In Hindi, it's tori. Tori and posto. This is tomato khatta.
Okay.
It's made out of mustard oil, panchputan, and dates.
Okay, so what is panchputan?
Panchputan is basically a spice. Like the ingredients are cumin, black cumin, mustard seeds, fenugreek. Those are the spices.
And what are these three things
over here?
That's
known as sago nadia. It's pronounced like this in Odia, sago nadia. That's a badi chuda. And that's known as begun bhaja.
Okay.
That marries well with the steamed rice while having with the lentils.
Alright, so this dish over here has its roots in the Bengali tradition. It's called jarni poshto, which if you don't know what poshto is, it's poppy seeds. And it goes perfectly well with the rest of these Odian thali. Alright, so when you come into a city for a few days, you can't obviously check out all the dishes that a cuisine has to offer. So you call for a thali, it's like meeting 10 different members of the same family. Well, you have something which is sour, you have something which is sweet, you have something which is hot and spicy. You get a taste of everything. And if you come here, you should definitely try out an Odian thali because this is by far one of the best cuisines I've had in all of India.